All right, hello, welcome. My name is QuiK Zero. This is QuiK Fitness. I do workout content and whatnot from my garage. Today, I wanted to do something different and record a little video that goes through basically a full body resistance band only workout that you can do from your house with $20-$25 worth of resistance band set that you can buy on Amazon. I'll probably link some below in the description. And yeah, I just wanted to kind of show how that workout would look. Do one set from each different lift. All that can be done at home using, the resistance band set. I'll show you what mine looks like here. Sorry, it's a mess. But yeah, there's about five different bands that are different colored, and they're all labeled with the different levels of resistance. Like this yellow one here, for example, is 5 pounds or 2.3 kilograms. So there's five different colors, five different levels of resistance, and then it comes with a handle on each side that you clip the different resistance levels to. And then it also comes with, or should come with, make sure it does come with, a door anchor, which I have here as well. Right here. So you slide this part, the bottom part here, through the door, then it gives you a loop that you can access from the other side, and you can slide your bands through it, and then you can do the different types of workouts. So you might hear me referencing this during the video. I'm not gonna be using mine because I have a squat rack that I can attach the rubber bands to, so no big deal. Also, I'm gonna be trying to do this in one take. I don't wanna edit anything. This is just gonna be what it is. So, what else do I wanna go over? I'm gonna put down like the actual routine down below in the description, but I'm just gonna kinda read out to you. Make sure you're doing three sets of each different lift that I'm gonna show you here. Your goal is gonna be between like 10 to 20. I know I put 10 to 15, but honestly with resistance bands, it's kind of hard to get, for at least an advanced lifter or someone who could lift a lot of weight, it's hard to get that high of resistance on some of the lifts without the bands literally like pulling you out of place. So 10 to 20 reps is kind of like a good place to try and hit. Once you're hitting 20 of a certain lift, or even 15, raise the resistance level. So add one of the other bands, the 5 pound band, the 10 pound band, to the bands that you're already using for that lift. Do the workout every other day to allow one day of recovery for the muscles in between. On those recovery rest days, you should be doing some cardio, light to moderate cardio. So, you know, a 30 minute walk, 30 to an hour. I'm not gonna tell you not to walk longer than 30 minutes. Go for a jog, biking. I have a rowing machine, assault bike, also a jump rope. You know, use your imagination. Don't just sit around, you know, do something productive on your rest days. I do have one rest day a week where I just do absolutely nothing, which is nice. But most of my rest days, I do like to have some kind of light cardio on. What else? Protein. I mean, I don't want to go too in depth onto the diet portion of it, but diet is very critical. What I do for diet is I do macro counting. I make sure I have 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight per day. And I make sure that I have a certain amount of calories. My, you know, carbs and fats, I don't really track as much. You know, they're automatically tracked through the app. I use MyFitnessPal for the app. And yeah, it's tracked, but yeah, as long as I'm getting 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight and I'm staying within a calorie range of, like, for me, it's 1800 to 2200 calories. That's kind of where I try to stay. And yeah, I can, you know, post details, or if you have questions, leave it in the comments below about, you know, if you have questions about what you need to do for diet, etc. This is mostly just to show you how to do each of the different lifts that we are going to be going through. So, the first one, Actually, I think I might pop this up. Did I add it? Let me add this layer to the screen right now, live while recording. Ready? Boom. There we go. There's the workout. Warm up. My warm up is just stretching. I can show you part of the stretching routine. Just to give you an example. I'll just go through it real fast. I hold each stretch for about 10 seconds. I'm not going to do that right now because this is just a quick and dirty video. So, each side, I extend the leg out like that. And I'm sure there's probably names for these stretches, but I don't know them. Newsflash. Nobody. I just kind of do this stretching that I learned in Little League baseball, like what 25 years ago. So for this one, I put one leg back and then let it stretch my quad out. Let's see if that on this side. And then stretch the quad. And then bring one leg over. That one feels really nice on your back. Nobody likes you, buddy. Nobody likes you. Nobody. Then I bring, I think this is called pigeon pose. It's from yoga. You have your knee out in front of you, like this. And then you lay forward on top of it. And it stretches out your glutes and hamstrings. And then I switch sides. Same thing. Then I bring it up, and then I stretch my calves out. I put one toe on the other heel and pull, and let it just work the calf. And remember, 10 seconds per side, per stretch. Then I bring my legs out. Then over, kind of stretch out the legs in between, the inside of the quads. Then I go to one side. Go to the other side.
It's time for you to learn.
Finish off with just a forward fold, I think it's called. Drum, you clap. Go as far as you can. Focus. Hold that for 10 seconds. That's my warm-up for lower body, upper body. Just pull one arm across, hold for 10 seconds. Other arm, pull it across, hold for 10 seconds. Interlace the hands behind your back. And then stretch out like this. That stretches the chest. Then arms over your head, grab an elbow, pull that elbow over. This will stretch your lats and your triceps. And your back. Switch sides, grab the other elbow, bring it down. Like that. And that's pretty much it. So, that's the warm-ups, the stretches. Now we're gonna jump into the routine. Again, I'm just gonna do one set per lift for each of the workouts listed up over here. That way you kind of get an idea. I'll try and explain as much as possible how to do it. Again, if you have questions on how to do it, leave a comment or find me on my Twitch stream when I'm live. And my Twitch stream is twitch.tv/ whatever. Quick Fitness. I changed my name recently. QuiK Fitness, QUIK Fitness. So, let's get it set up. The first exercise. Again, I'm also not gonna be swapping out the bands in between different workouts because, you know, that takes extra time and that's not relevant for this video. I'm just gonna put one resistance band on it with the handle and then I will show you how to do each of the different movements. For you guys at home, you will need to figure out which resistance level works for you, whether that is a 10 pound resistance level with a 5 added on to make it 15, or if it's a 30 with a 25 to make it whatever, 55. Up to you. But yeah, the sake of this video, showing how to do it, showing form, I'm just gonna be doing one resistance level for all the different lifts. don't do that because you will need to adjust it. Like, for example, there's no way I'm gonna be doing the same amount of weight for a RDL, which is your Romanian deadlift, that I am for curls. That is just not how it works. Some muscles are bigger than others. Your legs are stronger than your arms. That's just how it goes. So make sure you're adjusting for each workout. So for these, up to you. I alternate between doing the chest press with the band or just doing traditional push-ups. You don't need equipment to do push-ups. You can do push-ups on the floor. I just do as many as possible for 3 sets. So decide if you want to just do as many as possible push-ups or if you prefer doing the banded presses. It's up to you. So bring the door anchor back down to about chest height. Make sure the bands are even on both sides. You have equal resistance. Spin around. Gonna bring, try and make sure you guys can see me. Bring
video. I'll show you what a push-up looks like, but hopefully you know how to do a push-up. If you don't, this is what it is. And I would do just as many as you can. Like that. If you don't want to do, or if you prefer that over the exercise band chest press. That's, sorry. Okay, next. We're going to be doing flies, chest flies. Similar height, you're not going to move the door anchor. You might have to lighten the weight. Actually, you probably should lighten the weight because this is a more of an isolated movement. So, again, wrap around the door anchor. One foot in front of the other. Brace. Have your arms out. Have your elbows in a slightly bent but fixed position. You're not going to be moving your elbows in and out during this workout. You're going to have them fixed but slightly bent, and then do a flying motion like this. Arms out and forward and squeeze. Out, forward and squeeze. Out, stretch, forward and squeeze. Just like that. Again, three sets per workout. Or sorry, three sets per lift per workout.
Okay, and that does it for back and chest. Now we're moving on to our legs. So,
legs. We're gonna do squats. Squats first. Again, think resistance level that works best for you. Stand on the band, make sure the resistance level is even on both sides. Curl it up, wrap it around the back of your arms. And then we're just gonna bring our feet out slightly so they're around shoulder width. And then we do a squat. Bring it down, squat up, down, squat up. Make sure you're not falling forward. Make sure you're driving the squat with your heel. You want to try and keep the weight of the squat on your heel. Again, you don't want to fall backwards either, so keep your balance. But, here, let me show you from the side. Side view. Like, you don't want to be, like, just bending over like that. You want to be bringing your butt down and driving off your heel. So, butt down. Driving off your heel. But yourself, like that. That is the resistance band squat.
Now we're doing RDLs or Romanian deadlifts. For this, you're gonna wanna add a bunch more weight because
this is probably going to be your strongest lift. For this one, you're gonna wanna loop the resistance band into a circle in the middle here. So it's looped like this. It goes through and loops around. That way, you can have proper footing on the resistance band. You want to step on the resistance band with maybe like 4 inches, with 4 inches left on either side to the handle. So you don't want to have a lot of slag, or else it's not going to be any resistance at all for you. You want to stand about 4 inches from the handle on each side. Grab it, shoulder blades back, back flat. Brace, so take a deep breath, hold your stomach, and then bring the weight up. Squeeze your glutes, and back down, like this. That, let me show you from the side. Around again, sorry.
sets of 10 to 20 reps with a weight that is difficult for you. Next, shoulder press. So that covers legs. Now we're moving on to shoulders. Two exercises for shoulders. Shoulder press and lateral raises. So shoulder press. Stand on the resistance band. Equal resistance on both sides. Curl it up. Wrap it around the back of your arms. Get the resistance bands into the crease of your elbow. So right here on the back side. Right? And you're gonna keep it in that little pocket the entire time, the entire set. And then we bring it up over our head, touch the two handles together, bring it down, like that, boom. Hit the goddamn treadmill. Are you gonna be just like that? Squeeze, top of the rep. You can even do a little pause at the top, a little half second pause. Bring it down slowly. Bring it up. Pause. Bring it down slowly. Just like that. So you're from the side, not like it really matters from the side, but whatever. Again, this is where the band is for me. The band is wrapping around the arm right there and staying there the whole time. Just like that. As you can see, this is actually a good amount of resistance for me for that lift. Alright, oh yeah, don't mind the Christmas music, it's just a really hype bodybuilding song that happens to be Christmas themed. Anyways, so, next! Actually, I need to do this closer. Lateral raises. These ones burn so good, let me tell you. So, stand on the resistance band. Equal weight. Equal resistance on both sides. And bring your shoulders back. Brace, just like pretty much every workout. And bring your arms out to shoulder height or a little above, like this. One, two, just like that. And do it from the side. Just like that. Easy. Now the pace that you're gonna wanna do it, just like this. Out, pause, down. Out, pause, down. Out, pause, down. Just like that. And that covers shoulders. Next, we got the curls. So now we're moving on to arms. We're gonna do some curls and some triceps. Now for me, this is up to you if you want to do this or not. I like to put these two together. So they are smaller muscle groups. You don't get nearly as physically tired from doing these workouts. You get obviously tired in that muscle, but that doesn't mean you can't directly work out another muscle right after, right? So I like to superset, which means doing both of these next two workouts back to back without rest in between them, right? So I'll do the curls and I'll do the tricep extensions. Now, I like to do that because I use the same amount of resistance level for this workout for biceps and triceps whenever I do it, for real. So if you're at a point where, you know, you're either curling more than you're doing triceps, or your tricep extensions are, you can do heavier than your curls, don't limit one or the other because of that. And don't superset and then try and add more weight in between. It might just be a little cumbersome and like slow things down. So it's up to you. I'm gonna show you how to do it, show you the form. But
you don't have to superset if you do not want to. So, for curls, easy. stand just like you would expect. You stand on the weight or on the resistance band. Make sure it's even on both sides. Shoulders back. Curl up. Just like that. Down, up, squeeze. Down, up, squeeze. Down, up, squeeze. Be sure you're from the sides. Up, squeeze. Down, up, squeeze. Down, up, squeeze. Make sure you're keeping your head forward. I'm looking at the camera so I can make sure that I'm showing you correctly, but don't be twerking your neck to the side while you're lifting weights. That is not healthy. You might tweak your neck. I have before doing this. So be careful. And then, triceps. Put your door anchor on top of the door. And let me see. I might be a little hidden over here. Let me see if I can show you right here. Is this less hidden? No, I'm still hidden. Shoot. Alright, well, it is what it is. Just see what you can. I'll try to explain it more vividly. So, slide the weight or the resistance band through the door anchor. Drop down to your knees or drop down to a seated position, depending on how tall your door is. So either like this or down like this, whatever you have to do. For me, I'll like stand my knees for it. Bring your elbows to your sides and then extend your hands down to your sides as well. Just like this. You're probably gonna have to engage your core. Fine. Extend, squeeze, pause, up. Squeeze, up, extend, squeeze, up, extend, squeeze, up. Just like that.
And that is it for the bulk of the workout. I showed you the warm up. I showed you all the different lifts. Next is the ab superset. Now I do have a video dedicated to this and doing the full thing. I did it on my stream and then I clipped it and then I put it on YouTube. So if you'd rather watch the whole thing, you can do it there. What I'll do here is I'll just show you the three different lifts that I do. It's actually four because I do one of them twice. So let me explain it for you. The ab routine is just one set, one superset back to back to back of four different four ab lifts. First is a 1 minute plank. Then I do 50 crunches. You do as many as you can. Same with the plank. Do as basically plank as long as possible. As many crunches as possible and then push past that. So do 30, do 50, and then take a second, then do some more, and take a second, then do some more. Push past your failure level, okay? And then as many leg raises as possible. Same thing. I do 50, you do as many as you can. And then I do another 1 minute plank or as long as possible for you. Again, if you can't do a minute, do as long as you can, take a few breaths. Get back up, do a little bit longer. If a 1 minute plank is too easy for you, you don't want to be sitting in a plank position for 5 minutes or for 3 minutes even. What you want to do instead is make the regular plank a little bit more challenging. And how you do this is instead of having your elbows right below your shoulders, like in a regular plank, bring your elbows closer to eye level. And that will increase the resistance on your abs. You might feel a little shaky, which is fine, but it helps a lot. It helps a lot. That way you don't have to do a long, a long ab routine, or a long plank, sorry. So let me just show you what the form looks like on each of those. I'm not gonna do it again. I just finished my workout. I'm just doing this for you guys. So this is how it looks.
You might want to get an ab mat or something, so you don't, you know, so it's a little more comfortable on the floor. But plank. Lay down on your stomach. Elbows. For, you know, a normal person, you have your elbows below your shoulders. If you want to do the advanced plank, you would bring your elbows further out, right? So elbows below your shoulders. Get on your toes, get your toes ready, and then bring your abs up. So you're sitting like this. Let me show you from the side. So elbows, right there. Toes, and then up. Body flat, butt down, hold as still as possible. You don't want to be having your butt up in the air like this. You don't want to be sinking your back like this. You want to have your back flat. And then you just hold still. That's it. Do that for at least a minute or as long as possible. Then you roll over and you do crunches. Not full sit-ups, just crunches. Just like this. You cross your arms in front of your chest, or you need to hold your head for bracing your neck. That's fine too. Or whatever you do with your arms. As long as you're not swinging your arms around, it's fine. But yeah, just do a little crunches like this. Let me show you from the side here. Just like this. I do 50 of them. You do as many as possible. Then, we do leg raises. Still laying down, still on your back. I put my hands behind my head. You can put your hands underneath your bent lower back. Put them out to your side, whatever you like. I don't really care. Keep your legs extended out, right? And then lift them up like this. Just like that. Now, some people, if you want to try and add a little bit of difficulty to it, some people like to prop their butt up at the top of the reps. You bring your legs up and then just pop your butt up in the air like this and roll onto your lower back. Kind of like you're pushing your toes up towards the sky at the top of the rep. Now that's your leg raises. I do 50 of those. You do as many as possible. Then you roll over again. Back into plank. You know the drill. Shoulders under elbows, unless you're doing the advanced plank in which you would have your elbows out closer to eye level. And then you would bring your body up, so the only thing touching the ground is your toes and your elbows. Body flat, butt down, and holding as still as possible. Let me show you from the side again. Just like that. Body flat, butt down, hold as still as possible. 1 minute or as long as possible. And that is the whole routine. Like I said, every other day or 3 to 4 days a week to start out with, doing cardio on your off days, eating, you know, the correct amount of food, tracking your calories at the minimum. If you want to be an overachiever, tracking your macros. After you finish a workout, I highly recommend getting yourself some whey protein powder and having yourself a double scooper, you know, double serving or one serving if you're a smaller person, protein shake with water or with milk if you're trying to gain weight. There's some people that aren't trying to slim down, there's some people that are actually trying to bulk up. Have yourself a protein shake. Fuel your body. After you tear it down, after you don't build muscles in the gym. You're breaking them down. In the gym, you're telling your body, hey, I need you to grow. That's all you're doing. You're not giving it the fuel to grow. You're telling it, I need you to grow. Then you insert the diet portion, which is going into your kitchen or wherever, getting your protein powder, eating according to your goals. And to do so, I follow the If It Fits Your Macros regimen. You can Google that.
But for me, I just count my calories on MyFitnessPal and make sure I get 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight and make sure that I have the right amount of calories for my goal. So if you don't know where to start, count your calories for a week without changing your diet. Just eat normal, count your calories on the MyFitnessPal, dial everything that you put in your freaking mouth, any kind of liquids, any kind of food, anything. See how many calories you have, which is where your kind of maintenance is. Then lower that number by about 100 or 200 calories and stay there for a few weeks. Weigh yourself first thing in the morning after you piss and before you drink water, just so you get like a baseline. Your body weight will fluctuate with water weight. Like, I can gain 5 pounds in a day, easy, with water weight. So you want to look at the average numbers, but yeah, you're basically learning how your body operates normally and then changing the amount of calories, the amount of energy. Calories are a measurement of energy. I don't know if you knew that, but you're changing the amount of energy that you're putting into your body so you can tell your body, oh, I need to consume some of this energy storage, aka fat storage, in my body and turn it into fuel. Or I have an excess amount of protein. They just tore my muscles up yesterday. I need to build more muscle. You're telling your body what to do. If you want to bulk, you have an excess amount. You have an excess amount of calories. You have a sufficient amount of protein and you have a sufficient stimulus for building muscle from the gym, from the workout. Your body will put on muscle mass. The goal for gaining or losing weight is to try and find the sweet spot of calorie intake where you are gaining. If you're trying to bulk, then your sweet spot is 0.5 to 1 pound per week on average. That could be 2 pounds and then 1 pound and then 3 pounds and then no pounds. And as long as it's averaging out at around 0.5 to 1 over time. If you want to lose weight, you don't want to lose weight too fast either. Your goal, the sweet spot for losing weight, is to lose between 1 and 2 pounds per week on average. So track your calories, find the calorie amount that works best for you to hit your goals on either side of the spectrum. Have enough protein, drink enough water. I drink about 2 liters of water per day. Have your workout with your $20 worth of resistance bands to start out with. You can start out with barely anything. And take care of your body. Like, you only get one of these. There is no point in living your life, living your entire existence in a beat up 1995 Honda Civic when you could literally take care of your body and transform it into something that is an absolute pleasure to be in, to live in, to exist in. You could be driving around, figuratively, a Ferrari. So you can make your body into a Ferrari that you enjoy rather than a POS, you know, gas guzzling 20-year-old car that's falling apart. You have to go to the doctor every other week. You know, just take care of yourself. Mentally and physically. That's all I got for you. This went longer than I expected, but I really needed to make this video because there's a lot of people asking me for fitness advice and what do I do and, you know, hey, where do I start? And I don't have any equipment, and, you know, so this is my answer to you. Hope you enjoyed. That's it for me. 40 minutes is enough. So bye-bye. Is this the off button? I hope so.